Hi, I'm Heidi Hattendorf with Automation Anywhere. I'm pleased to be here today with Samir Dania from Tech Mahindra. Samir leads the global business development for platforms for Tech Mahindra. So Samir, thanks a lot for joining.
Thanks a lot for having me over.
Exciting times here at Mobile World Congress. So RPA is really taking off, and you've been in this space, you've met with a lot of customers, you've got a lot of great experience. Tell me what you think are some of the trends that you're seeing in the industry.
The industry is now well over its growth phase from a standpoint of an initial adoption happening.
Okay.
What we will see is more maturity happen with some of the customers that we initially started our discussions on as they move from task-based automation to what the industry is now terming as intelligent automation and driving larger business benefits enterprise-wide.
Yeah, that makes sense. And I think, too, one of the trends I've seen is moving from that back office to more of the customer-facing, business-impacting type processes. So no longer is it only about finance and sort of back office. Talk a little bit more about, you've talked about truck rolls and about the remote diagnostics. Tell us a little bit more.
I'm happy that you took note of what we have done on the truck roll side. I think that's a huge use case, which has clear business benefits that we can pass on to our customers. If you look at telcos, truck roll at an average costs them between 2,200 to 2,500 per truck roll.
Wow, yeah.
So huge cost. What we have done in there is that we have worked and integrated with the back-end systems.
Okay.
With the front-end essentially getting driven on what the industry is today calling as virtual assistants, okay, or chatbots, which enable scheduling to happen more accurately,
right,
more predictably, thus leading to a higher degree of customer satisfaction, a reduction in costs, and we're talking about automation percentages in the vicinity of 90-odd%.
Okay. That's amazing.
So it's a clear use case with business case benefits derived in possibly a time period of less than 6 months.
Yeah, just incredible. It's great to see the potential and the results and in real dollar savings for that. What would be another area that you would recommend customers to start if they're looking at where can I really have an impact?
If you look at automation today, is getting driven as one of the core functions of digital transformation that a CXO is looking at. Now, for that transformation to happen, it can't be piecemeal.
Right.
Okay. So it needs to be a continued process of transformation, driven on the background of automation, which is both on the business side, which is where RPA is working, as well as in conjunction with what we're trying to do on the IT or the operations.
Absolutely.
Now that becomes all-encompassing, where we are looking at front office automation, getting driven by RDA.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's the genesis of companies like Automation Anywhere and others, moving up to back office automation, and then looking at a combination of technologies to bear fruit. It's like being on a golf course, okay, with just a putter in hand, and looking at a 400-yard drive.
Right. You know where you want to go.
You know where you want to go.
Right.
Okay. You have clear line of sight.
Yeah.
You have bunkers and obstacles as well as you progress on that particular path. But just by taking a putter, you can't reach the green, okay, and you can't putt the ball.
You need the right tools to get you there.
Right,
you could have the vision.
Exactly.
Well said. I love what you said about connecting front office, back office, truly end to end, and in really having that vision for the digital transformation. Well, thank you so much, Samir. It's just been great.
Thanks.
Look forward to continuing to work with you and your team.
Look forward to more interactions.
Perfect. Thanks.